Hi, this is Paul Dembowski from Liberty Street Software. AssetManage asset tracking software was first released in 2005 and is used by thousands of customers all over the world. Our customers include small to large companies, police departments, schools, museums, and many other types of organizations. AssetManage is a Windows-based program that works in all versions of Windows XP, Vista, and Windows 7. Both 32 and 64-bit Windows environments are supported. You're currently looking at the main screen. As you can see here, it is divided into four sections. In the upper left, we have the location and department view. And this shows all the locations and departments defined in the program. The program allows unlimited locations to be created. Currently, we have the main office selected. To look at a department underneath the main office, for example, finance department, you just click on that, finance IT. And clicking back to the main office shows all the main office assets. At the bottom here we have a disposed assets folder. This is a dedicated folder that shows all disposed assets. Here we have an asset that was disposed on 2/24/2012 and the reason was abandonment. Deleted items folder. All deleted items or assets records are placed into here. Works in a manner very similar to the Windows recycle bin. In the right here we have an asset list which shows all the text data and a thumbnail image of an asset if it has images attached to it. You can sort on a particular column simply by clicking on the column header. Here we're sorting a brand name, department, and then finally asset number. You can reverse the direction of the sort by clicking on the header again. In the lower left we have the image view. Each asset can have up to 16 images associated with it. In the lower right we have a detail view which shows all the text data. For example, it shows any changes in status when an item was checked in, checked out, maintenance expenses related to the asset. Now if you click on one of the underlined text fields here, for example checked in, it's going to move to the status checked in and you'll see all assets with the current status checked in. Here we are now looking at all assets that are assigned to a particular employee. List of employees. The category view shows all the categories defined in the program. For example, you want to look at all the assets with the category file cabinet. You just click on file cabinet. Get rid of unwanted categories, select Tools Preferences, and here we have a list of unused categories which can be deleted if you wish. The View tab shows all sorts of different groupings of assets. For example, we can look at all disposals that happen in a particular month and year. Look at assets grouped by manufacturer, dealers, customers, disposal methods. To find some text within an asset, we can use the Find feature. For example, here we're looking at all assets with Herman Miller defined in one of the text fields. Click on the Go to Record to quickly select the asset with that particular asset number as shown in the items found list. You can run a report based on the results of a find as well. Barcode lookup lets you scan a barcode on an asset and quickly select the item. Here we're going to change the status of every item that is scanned to in use. So we scan the barcode 509. It's going to select asset number 509 and change the status to in use. Same with asset number 510. As you can see here, asset 510, the status has been changed to in use. There's a whole bunch of options here. You can set the last audited date, all sorts of things. The reporting feature has many predefined reports. To run run a report including only the assets of a particular location, just right mouse click, click run reporting using. We're going to show a list of assets here. Now you can output the report to many different formats: Adobe PDF, HTML, Microsoft Excel. Here we're going to just preview. Click start, and that is the report of assets from the main office location. Same principle applies to employees. Right mouse click on employees, select run report using. You're only going to see the list of assets that belong to that employee. Everything is context sensitive. AssetManage lets you output labels. So here we're going to output labels for the 5 selected assets. Select the label template. Output, start, and as you can see here, 5 labels have been created. Most of the time you're going to be using a dedicated label printer. You can also use Avery labels as well. AssetManage lets you edit reports using a built-in report designer. Here we're going to edit the asset list report, and as you can see here, we're going to select the table that appears in the report. And you can change data, the header that appears, you can change the footer that appears at the end of the report, the groupings, etc. You can check out assets and check them in using Asset Manage. Here we're checking out an asset by right mouse clicking on it. We're selecting the output checkout receipt, which will produce a checkout receipt. Thank you for listening. Please visit us at www.assetmanagesoftware.com for more information, including pricing, and a downloadable demo as well. It will work for 30 days.